Greetings of the day. I am Ranjit and I feel honored to express my views in front of you. So today's topic, we are independent or to make it straight, are we really independent? So the first question, what is independence? As all of you do, let's make a quick Google search. As per Wikipedia, independence is the condition of a state, country, region, etc. But I'll stop there because I will emphasize on one word, condition. So who will define that condition for us? And my answer is, it's us. I mean, independence is the state of mind. If we think we are really independent, then we are. To discuss it further, the recent events worldwide may force us to think that we are not really independent. The developments in the Taliban, developments in the Afghanistan, where the Taliban is coming into the power, we may think the people of Afghanistan are not really independent. The refugee crisis, they are dying in the seas. So are they really independent? If we come back to our own country, we are the largest democracy, but we are free to choose our own representatives. But if we ask the question to ourselves, are we really voting in with the free thoughts? Then we can get the answer, if we are really independent. Next topic, in our own country, the patriarchal norms are still visible. In many parts of the country, the child marriage is still there. The equality of the opportunity, equality of payment for the women are still a myth. The oppression against the women is still visible. So can we say we are really independent? If we are going to express our views in the social media, we are getting trolled. Our own society is asking us the question, judging us for our choice of our partner, choice of food, choice of OSIF. So can you say we are really independent? After this many years, the poor and needy fighting for their rights, sitting on the streets, the media trials are going on. But if we want the real justice, it takes years in the court. Every day the new terms are coming up. The mob lynching, the Andolan Jeevi, all those. So we have asked a lot of questions if we are truly independent, but we need to answer them. And for that, we need to go back to the pre-independence era. Before 1947, when our country was not independent, the nation was fighting for that. Do you think our forefathers were not independent, really independent at that time? If we think, Bapuji was able to do whatever and whenever he wanted to do, he was able to do that. In the other hand, Netaji has his own way, but he was also able to follow his own path. That means they were the people of free mind, free soul and free spirit. As Gandhiji said, it is never dear at any price, and this is the bread of life, and what the people not pay for their living. We need to answer the question that we have asked previously. So the Afghanistan crisis, a police personnel fought with the Taliban for 12 hours but never accepted defeat. The refugees are swimming across the seas but never accepted death. Women are getting oppressed. We are saying the patriarchal norms are there. We are crying for them. But many women are breaking the glass ceiling. They are never accepted the oppression in our society. We are not only making our own point, we are also bringing on some positive changes. And in my thoughts, that is the real independent. So only I can define my own boundaries, my own limits and my own norms. So I will repeat again, independence is the state of mind. If we want to be independent, then we will be. I'll conclude by quoting Ma'am Charlotte Bronte. I am nobody and no need incineration. I am a free human with an independent will. Thank you.